أشهد أن محمدا
created, he was not born, he did not give birth.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, the Eternal, is perfect and honored in every or all of his affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, He is perfect in His greatness. He's perfect in His forbearance. He's perfect in His wills. He's perfect in His knowledge. He is perfect in His wisdom. He is perfect in His honor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, the Eternal, the Everlasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad. He did not give a birth, he was not born. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, the Master, the one that all obey, and nothing happened without His permission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, the Eternal. All His creation needs Him in all their affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, He is the one that He would do whatever He wants. He would just say to be and it would be. No one will question Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, He is the one who will stay after all will perish. He will never die, and no one will inherit Him. He will never sleep, and He will never forget. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, As-Samad, this name was mentioned once in the Quran al-Kareem. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. This surah is a very special surah in the Quran al-Kareem. Equal third of the Quran. When you recite it, then you get the reward of reciting third of the Quran. When you recite it three times, you get the reward of reciting the whole Quran. In a divine hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَذَّبَنِي ابْنُ آدَمْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ ذَلِكَ وَشَتَمَنِي وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ ذَلِكَ فَأَمَّا تَكْذِيبُهُ إِيَّايِ فَقَوْلُهُ لَنْ يُعِيدَنِي كَمَا بَدَأَنِي وليس أول الخلق بأهون علي من إعادته وأما شتمه إياي فقوله اتخذ الله ولدا وأنا الأحد الصمد لم ألد ولم أولد ولم يكن لي كفوا أحد. الله سبحانه وتعالى saying in a divine hadith that son of Adam made a lie and he should not have done that. And he insulted me, and he should not have done that. For the son of Adam to make me lie when he said that he is not good, that Allah would not bring him back, and for Allah to create the Ibn Adam from the beginning is even harder than bringing him back. So bringing him back is easier. And for Ibn Adam to insult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أنا الأحد الصمد. I am the only one, the eternal. I was not born, I did not give birth, and nothing else with me, except for me. This surah, Al-Ikhlas, they mentioned, is a very special surah in the Quran al-Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love whoever will love this surah. Aisha radiallahu anha said that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent expedition and he made a leader for that expedition. And that leader In all his prayer, he was praying with Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. And the people would ask him, in him, is this the only surah that you pray with? He said, yes, it's what I like. If you don't like this, have somebody else to be the leader. And when they arrived back to the Medina, they complained to the Prophet and they told him. Then told the Prophet about that, so the Prophet ﷺ asked that man, why did you pray all the time with that Surah Al-Ikhlas? He said, I love the surah. So Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you for you loving this surah. Also, in another hadith, that someone would always, in another expedition, that he would always pray, and he end his recitation with this surah. And the people told him, either you pray with it or you pray without it. Don't mix the prayer ayah until add this ikhlas to it. He said, no. I'm going to do this. If you want, have somebody else to pray. Since he was the most hafiz, or the one who memorized the Quran, they let him, but again, they asked the Prophet when they arrived in Medina, and with the same answer. Allah loves you for you loving Surah Al-Ikhlas. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Tabuk expedition, Angel Jibreel told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muawiyah ibn Awiyah al-Mazni died. Do you like to pray on him, janaza? He said, yes. So Jibreel brought Muawiyah for the Prophet to pray janaza on Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Mazni. And when he finished, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw, and he told his companion that I saw two lines of angels, 6,000 angels each line, and all of them they pray for Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Mazni. What was the reason? Because he was always reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas, standing, walking, sleeping, sitting. All the time, Surah Al-Ikhlas was in his tongue. So, Surah Al-Ikhlas is very special, and many other good rewards for it, so you can search that, but this is just some of them. Surah Al-Ikhlas is also, you can protect yourself and your children with it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Osman ibn Affan was sick, he recited Surah Al-Ikhlas on him, and he was cured. The Surah Al-Ikhlas, Ma'awwidhatayn, when you are in trouble, when you are in need, when you are in asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, use this surah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is samad. He is the one that you ask for help in calamities. Whenever you need anything, ask the Eternal, the Samad. Reciting this name is a reason for responding to your supplication. He's the one who will remove the calamities from you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do. And he will make all the difficulties easy on you. And if anything happens, just recite Surah Al-Ikhlas and repeat the name of Samad. In sickness, وَأَيُّوبْ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to him. And if any problems happened around you, family, your community, just recite the Surah Al-Ikhlas and the name of Samad. Because the blessings will come with it. The problems will disappear with it when you say it with sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as-samad, the Eternal. Never eat, never drink. Whoever will eat and drink, That's his creation. The Christians, they call him with Isa, Jesus, as a son of God. Some of them they call him Lord God. How come creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will become a God and he came from the womb as a woman, from a woman, and sucked from his chest, and he lived, and he will die? Prophet Isa alayhi salam is still in the heaven, but at the end of the time he will come and will live normal, he will marry, and he will die. Prophet Isa alayhi salam, he was one of the prophets. ما المسيح ابن مريم إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل وأمه صديقة كان يأكلان الطعام. انظر كيف نبين لهم الآيات ثم انظر أن يؤفكون. The Yusuf in the jar was asked Mary, the mother of Jesus, when he saw her pregnant. He told her, how come it would be a plant without seeds? How the plant will grow without rain? And how a son will be without a father? This would be the indication of her condition. He received a response from Mary, the mother of Jesus. Yes, Yusuf, do you forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam without father and without mother? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the plants first without seeds and without branches and without anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything in the beginning without any original resources for him to say be, and it was. So Yusuf said, I knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do everything. So I needed for you to state that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as-samad, the eternal. He knows everything and nothing hidden from him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hadid verse 4, يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو معكم أينما كنتم والله بما تعملون بصير. Anywhere, everywhere, big or small, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. Anything get into the earth, how small, how big, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as-samad. He knows what's hidden, what's known. About the volcanoes, about the earthquakes, about the gases, about everything that the human knows and you don't know. On the heavens, on the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one that you ask him when you need anything, ask him for it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Abdullah ibn Abbas, Ya Ghulam, inni u'allimuka kalimatun minha, idha sa'alt fas'alillah, wa idha sta'ant fasta'an billah, wa'alam anna al-umma law ijtama'u ala an yanfa'uka bi shay' فَلَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ فَلَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. Oh, young man, I will teach you words. From these words, if you ask Allah. And if you need help, ask Allah for help. And be assured that if the whole nation, if the whole universe gather together and they want to do something good for you, you will not do that without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. all the universe gathered together so they can make harm for you, they are not going to harm you except with something that Allah written on you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summoned. When you repeat this name and when you learn about this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will feel sufficient than anybody else. Because you will always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dedicate whatever necessary for you in your need. With dignity. Stay with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and dignity is going to be with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summoned. When you know this name and you live with it, you will be honored. And your heart will be blessed. And your heart will be content. And when you feel that you are just one atom in this universe, and you are weak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you compare other creations to yourself, and look how strong some animals than you, look how big some animals or other creation than you, look how weak you are compared to any other creations, but know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. Have you in control of all this? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that trust in you, which is the mind. He put the mind in you. And He made you responsible about this trust. With this trust, you're going to be held accountable what you have done with it. Because no creation has mind like you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. All this creation, all the animals in the day of judgment, after the judgment between them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them to be dust and they will go dust. That's it. But for you, the humans and the jinn, they are not going to be dust. They're going to stay forever in the paradise if they did well. And God forbid, forever in the hellfire if they do bad. And the people who will go to the hellfire, they will wish that you would like a dust that the animals that happened to them. But that's not going to happen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distinguished the human, the son of Adam, and he will have all the responsibility on him with this trust that the mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. قول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعو الله عسى ان تكون هذه ساعه اجابه supplicate may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summoned the eternal. All his creations needed him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give provisions to his creation regardless if they worship him or they don't worship him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created his creation and has patience with no end. The disbelievers disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and still He gives provisions for them until the day of judgment, they will have the judgment between His creation And whoever obey him, follow his foot, follow his path, will go to the paradise. And whoever disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hellfire will be his place. But in this earth, patience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the most. Regardless of what the humans do during their lives. So when you learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is samad, did you ask him for all your affairs? And since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave all his creations what they need, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you that specific issue, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. If you can help somebody, this is a blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically chose you to do this. It's a blessing from Allah. Thank him for it. And do it well. And when you know that when you help someone in need, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a special reward for you. And we know this divine hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to son of Adam, I was sick and you did not visit me. Or I was hungry, you did not feed me. I was thirsty, you did not bring drink for me. And son of Adam will say, oh Allah, how I can do that and you are the Lord of the Lords. Say, don't you think that when you saw that person needed water, you did not give him water? That was for me. And that person needed food and you did not give him, that was for me. And that person needed some clothes and you did not give him, that was for me. You will find that with me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give rewards to when you help others in need. And don't remind that person what you have done. Do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not expect rewards from the son of Adam that you help, but always keep it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي حَاجَةِ أَخِيهِ كَانَ اللَّهُ فِي حَاجَةِ. If you will stand with your brother's need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for you. وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا دَامَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in your side when you are in the sight of your brother. اللهم إنا نسألك بأنك أنت الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد أن تغفر لي ذنوبي. اللهم إنا نسألك خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير النجاح وخير العمل وخير الثواب وخير الحياة. اللهم يمن كتابنا ويسر حسابنا وثقل موازيننا وثبت على الصراط أقدامنا وارفع درجاتنا واقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطايانا. اللهم إنا نسألك بعظمتك ومجدك وسلطانك أن تقبل منا وتغفر لنا وترحمنا وأن تصلي وتسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم خاتم أنبيائك يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي للصلاة حي للفلاة. كتبت الصلاة كتبت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
So I complete the third row, inshallah. Uncle to uncle. Still in the line. And Allah forgive us. And when you open the line, you open your legs like this. No. You always bring them as close as possible.
Back up the ring. Back up the ring. Back up the ring. straight.
Slant. It's supposed to be straight. It's supposed to be slant. That's fine. That's fine.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله Allahu Akbar.
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
استغفر الله.
استغفر الله.
السلام
عليكم ورحمة الله. Brother, we are in Shaban. You the benefit. Shahr Sha'ban was one soon going to be Ramadan, so Shahr Omar going to give us just a couple of words about the worship of Shahr Sha'ban. So good brother, and to be ready for Ramadan inshallah. Just a couple of minutes about
it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers, we all know, alhamdulillah, the fadl of Shahr Sha'ban. This is in preparation before the Ramadan. Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam used to fast. He used to do a lot of good deeds. So inshaAllah ta'ala, if we prepare ourselves, Shahr Sha'ban, as Ramadan comes in, that is the real great benefit. One thing I like to remind myself and to you, remember Allah who created us, who are Kareem, very generous. He will reward 10 times, up to 700 times, the goodness we do. He is so generous. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have forgiveness. Do not fast the last days of the Sha'ban, because that's not the Ramadan. People get confused. So, but if you used to fast a regular fasting, yes. So if you fasted, alhamdulillah, it's benefit, because it's a yawm al-shak. In the Sha'ban, the last days. So do not fast that days. Be careful. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.